From creatures that can cause gruesome deaths to others that functionally replace their host's organs, here are 9 creepy parasites you'll never want to encounter. Before we begin, be sure to subscribe to They Will Kill You. Hit the like button and request any topics you'd like to learn about in the comments section below. Number 9. Tarantula Hawk. Tarantula hawks are wasps that, much as their name implies, mainly hunt tarantulas. These creatures employ a particularly gruesome killing technique. The tarantula hawk is known as a parasitoid wasp. It will first grip the tarantula using the hooked claws at the end of its long legs. Then, the wasp will use its sting to paralyze its prey before dragging it to a specialized brooding nest. The wasp will then lay a single egg in the tarantula's abdomen and cover the entrance. As the larva hatches, it enters the tarantula's body and begins to feed. In order to keep the spider alive for as long as possible, the larva will typically avoid its vital organs during its voracious feeding. Ultimately, the wasp emerges from the spider's abdomen as an adult. To humans, the sting of a tarantula hawk is incredibly painful. Even though the most intense pain only lasts for about 5 to 7 minutes, it has been described as blinding, fierce, and shockingly electric. Unless an allergic reaction is triggered, the sting doesn't require any medical attention. Due to the fact that tarantula hawks own extremely long stingers, few animals are able to consume them. Their reputation in the animal kingdom is so fierce that many predators give them a wide berth, and other insects like beetles, moths, flies, other wasp species, or bees mimic them for defensive purposes. Number 8. Anelasma, Squalicola. Anelasma, Squalicola may be the only living representative of a barnacle species that made the transition from filter feeding to parasitism. This is evident in the fact that the CIRRI, structures once used for filtering food items, are present but no longer serve a feeding function. As a parasite, Anelasma extracts nutrition from its host through hidden tendrils that extend downwards from its body. Unlike most other barnacles, Anelasma squalicola doesn't have a shell. These barnacles are usually found in pairs, with their black-purple bodies protruding from that of their host. Anelasma attach themselves to several species of deep-sea-dwelling sharks. Castration is a common practice among parasites that attack invertebrates, such as insects or mollusks, but it's much rarer when it comes to vertebrates. For reasons that are yet unknown, Anelasma seem to castrate their shark hosts. Even though the tendrils the parasites extend don't reach the shark's genitalia, Anelasma seem to hinder sexual development in their hosts to the point of uselessness. Number 7. Trebius, Shiinoi. Trebius Shiinoi larvae, which typically infect Japanese angel sharks, will seek out the reproductive canal of a female host. After creeping their way through the canal, the larvae become permanently attached to the inner lining of the host's uterus. Trebius Shiinoi belongs to a broad category of parasitic crustaceans known as anchorworms. Once such a parasite latches onto a host, it cements its head into the tissue and loses all of its limbs. It then starts maturing into a worm-like tassel, which is soft and immobile. While most anchorworms attach themselves to the outside of a host, there are certain species that are more specialized. They will become embedded in a fish's anus, mouth, gills, or even the eyeballs. Even those that attach themselves to the skin might still send a blood-sucking tendril into a host's vital organ. Number 6. Epioplasma, Triquetra. This freshwater mollusk is native to North America, where it's listed as an endangered species. In 2004, it was discovered that Epioplasma triquetra, also known as the snuffbox mollusk, engages in a violent behavior when it spreads its larvae. During the larval stage, these mollusks are known to use the skin, fins, or gills of a host fish for nutrients. The creepiest part is how the larvae get onto the fish in the first place. The female snuffbox will first lure unsuspecting fish to them, then using its shell, lined with sharp little teeth, it will clamp down on the fish's head and proceed to pump the larvae into its gills. The common log perch is the mollusk's primary choice as host for its larvae because it's the only fish tough enough to survive the violent encounter. Number 5. Tapeworms. Tapeworms have a well-earned reputation as some of the worst parasites in the world, particularly for what they can do to humans. The eggs of these intestinal parasites may be transmitted through soil or fecal matter, but most people usually swallow them through undercooked meat. Without sufficient heat to kill the tapeworm eggs, they can eventually make their way to a human's digestive system. Once there, the eggs hatch and the larvae become adults by feeding on nutrients in the intestinal wall. Some adult tapeworms are hermaphrodites. They can produce more eggs. The symptoms of tapeworm infection are often very difficult to detect. That's why some may live inside the human body for decades, causing various conditions including malnutrition and a bloated stomach. During this time, they can also grow to incredible lengths, and there have been reports of tapeworms extracted from human bodies that measured up to 30 feet from end to end. Number 4. Barnacle's retinmyri. This tiny mite is known for its rather fascinating parasitic relationship with the army ant. Barnacle's retinmyri will attach itself to the leg of an army ant, from which it steadily sucks blood. However, this doesn't mean the ant has lost the functioning of its leg. The mite will use its own legs whenever pressed against a surface. The mite doesn't disrupt its host, as the main objective is to feed. The parasite basically acts as a foot, albeit a slightly more effective one, as it has 8 tiny feet at the end of it. This might prove particularly useful for army ants, as they're known to create linking structures with their bodies. The mites were named after American biologist Carl Rettenmeier, who was the first to study them. In his extensive work on parasitic mites living with ants, Rettenmeier also observed other mite species, some of which lived in the ants' eyes or at the base of their mandibles. Number 3. Ribereuia. Flatworms from the Ribereuia genus have been linked with causing the development of limb malformations in toads, frogs, and salamander species. Ribereuia undertrae cercariae, for example, are known to infect the developing limbs of amphibians in their larval state. They drill themselves into the buds that will eventually grow into legs. This can cause horrible malformations, which often consist of misshapen, extraneous members. These malformations severely hinder the host's ability to swim or jump, thus making them more vulnerable towards predators. However, amphibian larvae are only the second intermediate host for Ribereuia parasites, as their life cycle involves a complex sequence in the food chain. First, their free-swimming larvae will typically infect a freshwater snail. Once this happens, they will develop into worm-like parasites, which castrate the snail as they feed on its reproductive tissue. After about 6 weeks, they enter a second free-swimming form called cercariae. That's when they'll become attached to amphibian larvae or fish, where they enter a dormant parasite form called metacercariae. The fish or amphibian is then consumed by a bird or mammal, which becomes the parasitic definitive host. The parasite will emerge from its dormant stage and attach itself to the host's intestinal tract, where it will develop into an adult. Number 2. Saculina carcini. It's terrifying to imagine a parasite that can do to humans the same things that Saculina carcini does to the green crab. This parasitic barnacle will find a way to enter a crab and proceed to move through its insides. While it's doing this, it will release a sac on the underside of the crab's abdomen. The remaining part of the parasite will develop into tendrils that grow throughout the crab's insides, absorbing nourishment and controlling the crab's behavior. It slows down the development of the crab's reproductive glands and can cause male crabs to develop feminine characteristics, such as wider abdomens. If the parasite is taken out of the host, females will normally regenerate their ovaries, but males start to develop ovarian tissue as sex reversal takes place. Saculina carcini eggs develop externally, and the crabs will carry them around as if they were their own brood. The parasite manipulates the behavior of its host to the point that it no longer grows, molts, or regenerates lost limbs. Number 1. Cymothoa exigua. Cymothoa exigua is probably the creepiest parasite on this list. It's among the few known parasitic creatures that functionally replace one of its host organ. Cymothoa exigua will use its claws to latch onto the fish's tongue and slowly begin to feed by severing blood vessels. As it consumes all the blood in the tongue, the organ becomes atrophied and falls off. The parasite then attaches itself to the remaining stub and functionally acts as the fish's tongue. From that point on, Cymothoa exigua feeds on the blood of its host and fish mucus. This reportedly doesn't cause much damage to the host, however. Fish that have one or more of these parasites, which also may attach themselves to the gills, tend to be underweight. Once its host dies, Cymothoa exigua leaves its mouth cavity and clings to the outside of its body. Not much is known about what happens to the parasite once it becomes completely detached. Thanks for watching. What other creepy parasites do you know? Tell us about them in the comments section below.